Hi, I'm John, and in this IT Taster video series, I'm going to cover IP version 4 addressing. Now, each topic has been broken down into small, easy to digest segments to enable you to work through them at your own pace. In the first video, we'll examine what an IP address is. We'll look at IP addresses in their binary form, how to convert them from decimal to binary and vice versa, and we'll also look at the structure of an IP address. The IP, or Internet Protocol, is part of the TCP/IP suite of protocols. It's also important to be aware there are two versions of IP, IP version 4 and IP version 6. In this video series, I'm going to focus specifically on IP version 4. IP version 4 has been around for a very long time. It was intended to cater for approximately 4 billion devices. However, the internet has grown considerably since IP version 4 was first introduced, and in time it soon became clear that IP addresses were eventually going to run out, sooner rather than later. A new solution was needed, and this came in the form of IP version 6. However, IP version 4 still remains widely in use today, and it's going to be around for quite some time to come. So it's essential to have a good understanding of IP version 4 addressing and be able to build on that knowledge. In order for devices to send and receive information between each other over an IP network, each device must be assigned a unique form of identification. And this is what an IP address is. Everyone who has ever used computers and other network devices will have encountered an IP address that looks similar to this. However, an IP version 4 address in its raw form is a 32-bit binary number. As a network professional, you must have a good understanding of binary. You'll need to be able to convert an address in binary format to decimal, and vice versa. And when you move on to IP version 6 addresses, which are 128-bit binary numbers, your binary knowledge will be needed again. If you're not too familiar with binary or need a quick refresher, take a look at the Introduction to Binary video on the IT Taster channel. Okay, let's take a look at the example IP address of 192.168.0.10. If we were to write it down as a 32-bit binary number, it would look like this. These 32 binary bits are then broken down into 4 8-bit portions. Each 8-bit portion is known as an octet. This makes the IP address much easier to work with, especially when we need to convert it to decimal. To convert an IP address in binary format to decimal, we begin with the first octet, working from left to right. We need to transfer the 8 bits of the first octet to our binary table, and then add together the values of each bit that is set to on. 128 plus 64 equals 192. Which is the value of the first octet in decimal. We then need to repeat the process for the second octet. We need to transfer the 8 bits of the second octet to the binary table, and then add together the values of each bit that is set to on, which is 128 plus 32 plus 8, which equals 168. Which is the value of the second octet in decimal. The third octet is an easy one to convert. All of the bits are set to off, zeros, which is also zero in decimal. And finally, the fourth octet. We need to transfer the 8 bits of the fourth octet to the binary table and add together the values of each bit that is set to on, which is 8 plus 2, which equals 10, the value of the fourth octet in decimal. We arrive at the IP address of 192.168.0.10. Notice that each octet is separated by a dot or period. This is known as dotted decimal format. Dotted decimal format is how you will be expected to enter IP version 4 addresses for most network devices. But there are other tasks where you'll need to work with IP addresses in their binary format. And you'll also need to be able to convert an IP address written in dotted decimal format into binary. To convert an IP address written in dotted decimal format to binary, I'll use the example IP address of 192.168.0.10 again. And we begin with the first octet, working from left to right. The decimal value of the first octet is 192. We use our binary table to find the largest bit value that will fit into 192, which is 128. So we set the 128th bit to on by writing 1. We then subtract 128 from 192, which equals 64. And we repeat the process again using the remainder. The largest bit value that fits into 64 is of course 64. So we set the 64's bit to on by writing 1. We subtract 64 from 64, which equals 0. We have no remainder, so we set the other bit values to off by writing 0. This gives us the binary number 11000000 for the first octet. And we repeat this process for the remaining octets. The decimal value of the second octet is 168. The largest bit value that fits into 168 is 128. We set the 128th bit to on by writing 1. And then we subtract 128 from 168, which equals 40. 64 does not fit into 40, so we set the 64's bit to off by writing 0. 32 is the largest bit value that fits into 40, so we set the 32's bit to on by writing 1. We then subtract 32 from 40, which equals 8. 16 does not fit into 8, so we set the 16's bit to off by writing 0. 8 is the largest bit value that will go into 8, so we set the 8th bit to on by writing 1. We have no remainder, so we set the remaining bits to off by writing zeros. This gives us the binary number 10101000 for the second octet. The decimal value of the third octet is 0, so we need to set all bits to off by writing zeros. This gives us the binary number 00000000 for the third octet. The decimal value of the fourth octet is 10. The largest bit value that fits into 10 is 8. We set the preceding values to off by writing zeros, and set the 8th bit to on by writing 1. We subtract 8 from 10, which equals 2. 4 does not fit into 2, so we set the 4's bit to off by writing 0. 2 is the largest bit value that will go into 2, so we set the 2's bit to on by writing 1. We have no remainder, so we set the remaining 1's bit to off by writing 0. This gives us the binary number 0000001010 for the fourth octet. And we've converted the IP address from dotted decimal form into binary. This is a really useful skill, and one that you'll need as a network professional, and also if you plan to take network certifications. An IP address is made up of two parts, the network ID and the host ID. These two important pieces of information enable us to identify a network device. The network ID identifies the IP network the device belongs to. And the host ID identifies the device itself. Think of this in a similar way to the addresses we use for street buildings. The street name can be compared to the network ID. All buildings belong to the same street and share the same street name. In this case, Network Avenue. Each building can be compared to the host ID, a network device, which has a unique number to identify it. Therefore, this building can be identified as Network Avenue, Building Number 4. In the case of our IP address, we might say the network is 192.168.0 and the host device is number 4. Our street address and example was of course very simple. In the real world we have lots of different streets and buildings. And IP networks are just the same. We have many networks and host devices all over the world. IP addressing is able to deal with this, and we'll work our way to that later in the series. Okay, we've covered the basics of what an IP address is. We've examined them in their raw binary form, and we've also learned how to convert an IP address in decimal to binary and vice versa, as well as the structure of an IP address. In the next video in this series, we'll learn how we determine which part of the IP address is the network ID and which is the host, when we examine subnet masks and how they work. Well, I hope this video has been helpful. Please subscribe to the IT Taster channel. Your comments are welcome, and thanks for watching.